The Department of Radiology has recently acquired a new mobile CT that can be combined with a conventional fluoroscopy. And this greatly benefits a small number of diabetic foot patients that require both a foot CT and an intra-arterial angiography. We are also researching a completely new scanning method, or a time-resolved angio CT scan. Time-resolved angio CT scanning is also called 4D scanning because it adds a fourth dimension time to the conventional 3D model that a standard CT provides. And what we are specifically looking at is the buildup or washout of contrast to and from a target tissue. As an example, time-resolved CT angio scanning is perfectly capable to distinguish between arteries and veins because the former receives contrast in a much earlier phase than the latter. In regard to the diabetic foot, we hope that time-resolved CT angio scanning will help in establishing the diagnosis of critical limb ischemia in a more accurate way, as we are looking more specifically to tissue perfusion.
To get the best of results, we will need a combination of spatial resolution, which means like the collimation width of at least 160 millimeters, combined with a height temporal resolution, both in scanning rotation time as a minimum interval delay between actual scans of at least 1 second. Because you start out with at least 30,000 images with the added four-dimensional temporal aspects. All of these images have to be processed to obtain the essential hemodynamic information as well as the vascular structure to end up with an image that is that's for the vascular surgeon and the radiologist too easy to comprehend. Well, actually, it doesn't make that much of this difference, because we take the well-established examination technique that is CT scanning, and we only add the temporal aspect to it. And for the patient, it only contains an additional 2 cc of contrast injection to obtain this large amount of extra information.